Hello friends, welcome to Commoner series of Smart Leaders IAS. In this video, we'll be seeing about the great thinker, B.R. Ambedkar. So whenever ideals of Indian constitution are put into question, for example, in Article 35A are into news, or on the other hand, economically backward session are given reservation. Whenever such a change is in the news, the personality which we come to remember is B.R. Ambedkar, who drafted our Indian constitution. So B.R. Ambedkar is not just a drafter of Indian constitution, but also he is a great social reformer, politician, an economist, a jurist, and also a sociologist. So he was such a multi-faced personality, and he played a very important role in India's freedom struggle. So in this video, we'll be seeing about B.R. Ambedkar in detail. So B.R. Ambedkar was born on 14th of April in the year 1891. He was born in a place called as Mahukand in the state of Madhya Pradesh. So from his early age, Ambedkar faced a lot of struggles in his life, and those struggles shaped his life to a person he was in the later part. The biggest barrier in life of B.R. Ambedkar was the concept of untouchability, which is practiced in Hinduism. The family of B.R. Ambedkar, they belong to a class of people called as untouchables according to the tradition of Hinduism, due to which he was surmounted to great number of trouble in his life. So in the year 1908, B.R. Ambedkar, he passes matriculation exams from the state of Bombay, and he also went on to complete his graduation from the same state. After completing his graduation from political science in the Bombay University, he went abroad to Columbia University to further his studies. So between 1913 to 1917, he stayed in America. Later on, again from 1920 to 1923, he went on to go to London for his further studies. In between such a stunt, he also taught in the College of Bombay for a couple of years. So when he was teaching in the College of Bombay, he started his first weekly called as Mook Nayak in order to spread awareness about the concept of untouchability. So after his period of stay in London, Ambedkar decided to come back to India in the year 1923, and he returned back to India in 1923, the April month. During this time, Ambedkar fully equipped himself to wage a full-fledged war against the concept of untouchability. So meanwhile, he studied the political situations existing in our country that time, as India was under the British rule. So he understood that he needed to make substantial changes to understand the problem, to spread awareness to people about the concept of untouchability and the stigma associated with untouchability, and also to provide solutions to the problem of untouchability. B.R. Ambedkar not just worked for the upliftment of Harijans, but he also worked for the welfare of the oppressed class and also women. So in the year 1923, he started his first organization in India. The name of the organization is Outcast Welfare Association. And this association, it worked to increase the education penetration among the Harijans. By improving the education, he owed to touch and improve the economic status of the Harijans in our country, and thereby finding the solutions to many forms of problems and the stigma they place in their everyday life. The first problem which Ambedkar touched upon was getting entry of the Harijans into the temples and also allowing them to access public facilities like the water wells. So in the year 1927, he organized a march called as Mahad March at a place called as Kolaba in Bombay. And this marked the beginning of anti-caste and anti-priest movement in our country. And in the year 1932, Ambedkar signed a pact called as Pune Pact with Gandhiji. And this Pune Pact, it decided to provide reservations for the Harijans instead of providing the communal award as announced by Ramsay MacDonald. This incident, it opened up the further opportunities in the sector of education and also reservations for the Harijans in the field of government jobs in the days to come. So apart from this, Ambedkar also went to London to participate in all three roundtable conferences. So in 1940s, when the Constitutional Assembly was formed, B.R. Ambedkar was announced as the president of the drafting committee of Indian Constitution. Even though the country at that time was facing several crises due to partition, B.R. Ambedkar finished off his job and provided the Indian Constitution with the ideals of social justice, unity, dignity, as well as freedom. The rights of scheduled castes and scheduled tribes was protected as per Indian Constitution. And Indian Constitution also stands as the longest running constitution among all the constitutions in the world. The constitution drafted by Ambedkar took into consideration the needs and the aspirations of all the diverse religious and the linguistic communities existing in our country. Being the chief architect of Indian Constitution, B.R. Ambedkar was also bestowed with the title of Bharat Ratna in the year 1990, and the birthday of B.R. Ambedkar, that is April 15th, is also celebrated as the Ambedkar Jayanti throughout the country. Also, the period from 14th April of 1990 to 14th April of 1991 is celebrated, is observed as the year of social justice in the memory of B.R. Ambedkar. So even though B.R. Ambedkar died in the year 1956, his ideas and ideologies are still valid to the contemporary Indian society. Without the works and achievements of B.R. Ambedkar, the history of modern India is definitely incomplete. So thus, B.R. Ambedkar is a great visionary and his legacy still lives in the minds of all the Indians. Thank you.